Hi everyone, in this video I'll explain how to use loops with arrays. And I do a small example here. First I declare and initialize an array. So I use float here, some values, and new float. And I use four different elements that I can store in the array. Now what I want to do is I want to prompt the user to input the values. So this is the input. And for that, I use a scanner. So create a scanner object. And I'll use a loop starting with index 0, index less than values.length. So this goes from 0 until values minus 1. Make sure you don't do less than or equal to, because this will cause an index out of bounds exception. And then do I++ for every element. And here I simply output a prompt, enter plus an I plus 1. The reason why I do I plus 1 is that the prompt will start at 1, 1, 2, 3, 4. Because this is kind of how humans start counting at 1, the computer starts counting at 0. And now I want to access the values. So values at index I equal to scanner.next float. So this reads the next floating point value, stores it at index I. And I is initially 0, so it's the first prompt will store it at index 0, then increment it, then index 1, 2, and 3. And then the loop will stop. Now here I want to output this information. And for that I use a different loop. It's called the for each loop. So for each element of the array. And this is written as for. The element type is float. And I call this val. And colon. And then the array values. So this we can read for each float in the array values. And here simply output print the value plus a space. And then at the end, I just put a print line. Now let's run this. So I created an array of four. It prompts me here. So I put 2.5, 3.7, 1.0, and last 9.8. Hit enter. And now we can see we get it iterates here over the values 2.5, 3.7, 1.0, and 9.8. So first loop is an index-based loop. I have an index. The second is a for each loop. This is really convenient if you simply want to go over all the elements in an array and do something with the elements. The index is good if you want to write to the elements, if you want to update them, or if you want to just partially access them, maybe from the fifth element on, or you want to go in a specific order from the last element to the first element if you go in reverse order. So these are the different ways to use loops with arrays. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching.